So what I want to show you, I want to show what I actually received from Amazon. I received these. This is the remote control. The company is called Yuki Glass, okay? And I received that one to put it in. And I received the receiver here. You can see the receiver? I just want to show you how small is this receiver in comparison with the receiver that used to be before. That is the receiver used to be before, that is the new receiver. And I just want to tell you something about this receiver with the remote I bought from Home Depot, I believe. It cost me like $40 or $35 or $40. While this and that cost me $15 from Amazon. So I just want to show you how easy it is to connect it and to install it and run it. So now we're going to connect this receiver. As you can see here, there are two input here, neutral and hard, that come from the ceiling, and there are three output. This one going to the blue going to the light, this is the neutral, and this one is going to the motor, and this is the antenna. Okay, and here is the remote control is here, as you can see, come without batteries. I have purchased two batteries, it's AAA, and that one we're going to talk about it later. But now what I'm going to do, I'm going to connect it here. As you can see, let me show you from here. From here, I'm going to actually connect it to the canopy here. I'm going to put it inside the canopy, and then I'm going to connect the wires, and I want to show you how I'm connecting it. Okay, and the first thing to do is, remember, this is the light here. You have to put it off, shut it off, correct? Let's go. So this fan, like every fan almost, coming with four wires, okay? You can see here, there are green, blue, black, and white. The black and white, the black, okay, that's it. The white going to a neutral. The black is going to the motor, the blue is going to the light, and the green that I'm actually holding it in my hand. Let me show you, this is the green one, it will go to the ground. Okay, so the first thing we're going to connect is the ground. Okay, I want to show you, the ground is here really. It's difficult to see, it's here. Okay, it's coming from the ceiling. Let me show you from other angle to show you where is the ground. So here's the ground, as you can see here. You can see it's exposed wire here. It's really wire, you can see it here, it's connected to the metal here. Here my finger show here. It's actually coming from the ceiling. The ceiling is here. And both of them connected to this screw. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this connector, the red connector. Okay, so you can see how it's exposed. And then I'm going to take this wire. Remember the wire that I showed you, the green wire that's coming from the fan? There are four wires, one of them is the green, that is the green one. I just put it here, and then what I'm going to do, I'm going to put both of them, that and that, together. Okay, and just connect it together. Okay? So you just connect it tightly. And that's it. After connecting these two wires to the ground, I just push it in. Okay, inside here. Okay, just to have more space. Okay, I'm actually putting the space for the receiver to go into this area, you see? This small receiver should go in. So this wire that you see, it's the neutral coming from the ceiling, okay? That is the input. And there is another wire here, you can see it here, I'm taking it here. That is the hot coming from the ceiling, okay? It's here. That is actually the input to the receiver, and the output of the receiver had to be connected to these three remaining wire, blue, black, and white. So now if you look at the canopy here, you can see here, you see what I'm touching it? This kind of a bump, okay? That's actually stop the receiver. When you put the receiver inside the canopy, that's actually stop it from moving there. So I have to put the receiver really from here, okay, From this, you can see my finger here. I'm going to put it here, and it's going to go here. This receiver is small, okay? So it's going to be very easy to pull. That's what I want to show you, how to put this receiver, because other receiver, you're going to have sometimes difficulty. So here is the receiver in my hand. What I'm going to do, I'm going to pull it here. You can see what I'm doing? Actually, starting moving it, okay, here. And if you see, I'm actually pushing it. Okay, I'm pushing it and I'm just pushing it until the end. Okay, here you can see it actually stopped here. And the receiver, it's really difficult to see because of the color here, but you can see the receiver is actually here. Here is the beginning of the receiver, you see? Okay, and it's inside the canopy. It's very important, it's going to be inside and we reach until this point. Here it stopped, as you can see. Okay, and this is two wire. This is the input of the receiver. That's the neutral will connect to this, and the heart will connect to this. That's what I'm going to do now. Before I'm going to connect it to the ceiling, I'm going to connect this wire first. Okay, so the first wire we connect is the ground. Now we have these three wires. So these three wires have to be trimmed properly in order to connect. So this wire is actually the output of the receiver. As you can see, this is the receiver, it's here. The three wires, okay, black, white, and blue. We need to connect them to these three wires that are coming from the fan. As you can see, it's very long, so I'm going to cut it here. So I can cut it with my plier here, okay? Go in and just give it a nice air cut. Okay, it's a little tough to cut it with this plier. Okay, it's gone. So okay, we trim these wires, you see, we don't need so long wires here. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to expose these three wire insulation, okay, so that I can connect them to these wires. Okay, let me do it and I'll show you the end result. So these are the three wires after I remove the insulation and I expose them. And now I'm going to connect them to these wires here. This is a nice stuff that I received from the company Yuki Halu, okay. This is connector. You can see the connector here, it's really interesting. You can still using these connectors, but this connector is really interesting because I can use it for the three wires by just flipping. There is kind of a valve here, you actually press it and you push the wire in from two directions. So I can actually connect here the three wires, the white, the blue, and the black together, okay? And here I connect the ceiling. So I don't really need to use it, even though they come with that if you don't want to use these. So I'm going to use that one to see what is the result, but it's going to be very easy. So let's do it. So I'm taking this black wire, okay, as you can see here. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to first push one of them, the black. You can see I push it in, and then you push it and you love it, and you leave it like that, and you take the black from the other place, from the other direction, and you push it in. Okay, so now you have the two of them are connected. Same thing you're doing with the blue. Okay, it's in. Then I'm going to take the blue. As you can see, it's very easy to work with it, really. And here is the white, the neutral. The last wire is the neutral here. You can adjust it by actually just flip it like that. Press it here and push it. Push it inside. And that's it. You finish all the connection. So what left to do now is to connect the neutral to the neutral of the receiver here. That's the input. That's the actually wire that comes from the ceiling. And this is the input to the receiver here. And if you see, I can remove it easily in my hand. The same thing with these. Remove it very easily, the insulation here. So what I have to do, I have to take this wire and connect it to here. That's the neutral. See, and for that one I will use this connector, connecting both of them together. Okay. So I just wrapped the white wire here that is the input to the receiver to around the wire that's coming from the ceiling, the neutral. And I'm actually using this connector, the yellow one here that you can see, and just starting to put it together using it. You need to use both of your hands. I use both of my hands. With both of my hands, you just need to make it very strong, tight, and that's it. But I use both of my hands here, so you really need to use, because I cannot use both of my hands because my one hand is holding the camera. But you have to start here and then with the other hand flip this, which means rotate it with the clock, just to close it. Okay, I'm taking these two wires, you can see. There are two. That is the hard coming from the ceiling, and this is the hard that they input to the receiver. And what I'm doing here, I'm just flipping it here, using this connector, and quite tight, you see. That's the way you have to do it. Okay, make sure there is a connection, and this connection will never fail. Until now, as you can see, this is the two wires that coming from the ceiling, the hard and the neutral, and they are connected to the input of the receiver, which is here. And there is another three wires that we already connected. Let me show you. So this is the three wires that are connected here. As you can see, the black, the blue, and the neutral, and they are connected to the black and blue and neutral. Okay, one of them from the fan and the other one to the receiver output. Okay, so the receiver output is connected to the fan input. Okay, the light is on. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to shut the light off. It's working perfectly. Turn it on, it's working perfectly. So now what I want to do, I want to go to low. So you can see the low going, and I can go even to medium. And now I can go, you can see I'm actually pressing the high. As you can see, the high is really, really, really running here. I really feel cold. Okay. And turn off the light, turn on the light, and you can actually stop it if you want. Okay, so what's nice in that remote and this Yuki Halo company, that it costs between $10 to $15 on Amazon, free delivery. Okay, it's working the same or even better than the one you buy from Home Depot or Lowe's. That costs you $10 to $15 to install it. It's easier, and I believe it's also reliable because using new technology, semiconductor and everything packed down there. So it seems to me it's in better quality. So remember, when you want to buy a remote control or receive a remote control, you can get it for $10 to $15, and you don't really need to go to Amazon or not to Amazon, to Home Depot, Lowe's, other shops.
and pay $40 or $30 for it.
So the only thing that left is to put this handle for the remote control here. So as you can see, I already marked it. There is two holes here, one, two. What I'm going to do, I'm going to drill here. One hole and second hole here. Let's see if it's not, because I use 3/8. Let's see if that one will go. No, we need a bigger one. One anchor is in. So that is the second anchor.
Thank you for watching this video.